Hi, Gaylerd here. Welcome back to the Big Dog Challenge. In this lesson, I'm going to show you the notes to use, the basic notes to use when you transition from the A chord to some of the basic chords. That's like to the F, to the D minor, to the C, to the G, and to the E. Those are the basic chords. There's lots of chords that you can transition to and lots of notes that you can use. But these are the typical notes that I'm going to use to transition to just about any chord and back to the A minor as well. So hey, this is a great lesson for you. Good finger dexterity, great notes to learn. You're going to want to learn these, so what am I talking for? Let's get back together in the studio and I'll show you how to put these notes together for transitions. Okay, let me go ahead and show you the notes that we're going to use for the A minor chord, and you're playing on the 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1 strings. Okay, so here we go, and you're going to do open 5, 2 on 5, 3 on 5, open 4, 2 on 4, 3 on 4, open 3, 2 on 3, open 2, 1 on 2, 3 on 2. Now, you've got an open 1, 1 on 1, and 3 on 1, but a lot of times, instead of playing that open E, I'd like to do a slide up to that E note by getting it on the 5th fret of that 2nd string, okay? So You might want to just slide up. It's the same note that you're playing, but I like that little slide up in there. Okay, now let me show you how to do some transitions. What's important on the A transition, we're using those notes, and once again, you want to make sure that whatever chord you go to, you want to make sure that you start with that bass note of the chord. So we're going to go from an A minor to a C. That means that the C note, we want to hit that bass, the 3rd fret on the 5th string, as our first note when we hit that chord. So here's what we're talking about. And you can play those notes in any progression, any kind of a format that you want to play, as long as when you hit that chord, and the strum beat would be the same too, same no matter what strum you're doing. You're doing different, you'll be hitting different notes for different strum beats, but it's always the same. You always want to wind up with that bass note on that chord. Okay, so here we go. We're going to start off with the A minor and we'll get to the C, and I can use any of those notes as long as when I hit that C chord, I'm starting with that note right there. So on this transition, I'm just going to start off using my 3rd, 4th, and 5th strings on this first little set here so I can show you what I'm talking about. So here's A minor. See what we did? All those notes are in that progression. Are in those A minor notes. And I usually use, if I'm just going back to that same chord, I'll use the same notes that I was using. Okay, now here's another way to do it. See, there's that slide that I'm telling you about. It's still that note, right? We're sliding up. And that note right there is the open 2. So we're good there. And all I'm doing there is a slide down. And I don't have to show you the tabs on these, because you can do anything you want to do with those notes that are on that tab as long as you start hit that C right there. Let's try it with a D minor. So a D minor means that we're going to hit that open 4, which is the D note, right? So we're on A minor. Now notice what I did there. I'm hitting that multiple times on that open 4, because when I was, the notes that I chose, I just happened to hit that open 4, but I have to make sure when I hit that D minor that I'm hitting that note as well. So, yeah, I could have. Whoops. Now you can hit that note. Remember, you're not restricted to just those notes. Feel free, make some music, man. Do what you need to do. But those are the basic notes. If I hit another note in there, if it sounds good, keep it in. If it sounds bad, throw it out and don't use it again. with my A minor, just go back to that D. There's your D. Let's try going to an E chord, okay, from the A minor. Using those same notes, we've got to make sure when we hit that E that we're open sixth string, okay? And you do the same thing playing an E or an E minor, okay? So let's go from A to E. Whoops. Now, I'm going fast, I understand that, but I'm just trying to show you that it really doesn't matter what I'm playing because you're not trying to copy this. You want to do your own as long as you're using those notes that are on that tab and ending up with your first note on that chord. I know I'm repeating this over, but it's very important. Let's try it with a G. Now here's something cool. When I'm from that G, one thing you can do there, you can do a nice little slide. And this, I love using slides, it just adds wow factor to it. And the slide that I'm using here from the G to the A, I'm gonna put my index finger, first fret on that first fret on the second string, middle finger I'm putting the second fret on the third, and I'm just sliding up two from the G. Right there, second fret on the fourth string, and then A. So I'm making sure that I hit that A open. So it, right? Because you gotta hit that A. Back to G, let's try it again. And sometimes, look at my hand motion, sometimes I'm going always down on it. Sometimes I'm back and forth using that paintbrush, painting those strings. There's the A minor. You're going to have fun with that. Pretty soon we're going to put these into together in a song, and you're going to use the notes and the different transitions to put your songs together and bring the chords together. All right, there's the A minor, and let's practice that. Make sure that you are being able to change to your chords smoothly. You've got to be able to change it smooth. When you hit that chord, it's got to sound smooth. So don't move on until you've got those down, okay?